welcome to St. Patrick's Cathedral Dublin for the next in this series of recitals by the organist and assistant master of the music, Mr. David Leigh, on the Willis organ. The programme which David has chosen features music exclusively by J.S. Bach, works which illustrate the composer's genius and virtuosity. I trust that the music will bring you not only enjoyment, but that it will also provide a sense of peace and serenity in these stressful times. Bach's parents died when he was 10, and after being cared for by his eldest brother for the next 5 years, he won a choral scholarship to the school at Michaelskirche, Lüneburg, which undoubtedly influenced his interest in church music and the organ. His innate genius was confirmed 3 years later, when aged only 18, a brilliant performance he gave on a new organ in a church in Arnstadt resulted in him becoming its highly paid organist. Rather ironically, his sparkling virtuosity as a player, together with his desire to demonstrate the organ to the full, led to the church council letting him leave this post in the face of criticism from the congregation that his embellished playing was causing confusion. The first work in this programme, the Prelude and Fugue in E minor, BWV 533, which Bach composed when he was about 20, provides an oral aid to understanding Bach's genius. In the prelude, there are short pedal solos, shaking tremolos for both hands, and a series of full chords for keyboard and pedal simultaneously. All exciting musical elements which can also be used to explore the qualities of an organ. These elements return in the fugue, which opens with a moving theme, first modestly and almost hesitantly, but later with increasing assurance. Towards the end, there is a passage where Bach makes the left hand stand out rather dissonantly against the right hand, precisely that to which people in Arnstadt were objecting. The Prelude and Fugue in E minor, BWV 533.
Thank you.
During his school days in Lüneburg, the young Bach became acquainted with the organ virtuoso Georg Böhm, who was a master in the art of variation. Through Böhm, Bach also came into contact with Reinken and Buxtehude, who were both composers with a flair for the art of variation. There was much that Bach could learn from these masters, but the challenge of variation must have held particular appeal for the young composer. This is where the chorale partita, a special form of chorale arrangement, enters the scene. The chorale, or hymn, serves as the starting point for a series of variations. The five compositions by Bach bearing the name of chorale partita do not come from a single source, nor are they dated, but it is supposed that they originated in his teens and may have been revised later on. The main role in his chorale partitas seems to be given to pure pleasure in playing and inventiveness. So we stay with the young Bach, who chose a hymn rarely set to music for his chorale partita Sei gegrüßet, Jesu gütig, which implores God for guidance through suffering and eventual death, and bears close parallel with the themes of the crucifixion story. In what is one of the longest works for organ in his repertoire, Bach, in 12 variations, explores the harmonic, rhythmic, and stylistic possibilities of the melody, forming the base of the piece, thus illustrating the genius and virtuosity of the young composer. The chorale partita Sei gegrüßet Jesu gütig, BWV 768. From Bach as a young man, we move on now at least 20 years or possibly more to his time at Leipzig, where between 1727 and 1736 he composed a work which strikingly reveals his total individuality. Bach's Prelude and Fugue in E minor, BWV 548, known as The Wedge, is especially treasured by connoisseurs of his music. It is thought, as one writer expressed it, that Bach intended this superior work for an equally superior audience. Besides being one of the longest organ works by Bach, the Prelude and Fugue in E minor is also one of the most complicated. It earned the subtitle The Wedge because the first half of the fugue subject opens up as a sort of widening chromatic wedge around the tonic point. The Prelude's massive structure is considered to be one of the most intricate in the genre. It bears a concerto-like style, similar to other mature organ works such as the BWV 544 and the BWV 546 Preludes, with the opening theme reoccurring between various polyphonic episodic sequences. The brilliance of the fugue, which is among Bach's longest and most elaborate, has been described as nothing short of bewildering. With its soloist passages, intricate toccata-like sections of great virtuosity, scale fragments, and da capo structure, one is said to be left feeling perplexed at the genius of Bach. In fact, the late Dr. Albert Schweitzer, theologian and organist of note, contended that this work needed to be heard many times over to appreciate fully the sheer brilliance and individuality of Bach. J.S. Bach's Prelude and Fugue in E minor, The Wedge, BWV 548.
Thank you.
performance by David Leigh on the organ of St. Patrick's Cathedral, Dublin, of J.S. Bach's Prelude and Fugue in E minor, BWV 548, brings today's recital to a close. As always, we offer David our deepest thanks for his virtuosic performance of this programme of music by Bach, and also for all his tremendous work in preparing this series. Thanks also to you for listening. I do hope that you will keep in touch and join us again for the next recital, which will feature C.S. Lang's Organ Sonata in D minor. Until then, please take care and keep safe and well.